Good morning, students. Welcome to the English class. I am Roopna Ravindran, Assistant Professor of English, Government Degree College, Cheverla. So today, let us discuss the topic active and passive voice. Voice is actually an aspect of the verb that shows if the subject is acting or that particular action is done to the subject. Okay? So it is the two ways in which the same sentence is told. In active voice, you have sentences with an action verb, and then the subject will be performing the action that is denoted by the verb. If I give you examples, then you'll be able to identify the active voice easily. Okay. Here, there are a few examples. See, she drives an SUV car. So here the importance is given to the subject and how the subject performs the action. Okay. That is received by a direct object. Okay. So here she is the subject, drives a verb. An SUV car is the direct object here. He is making rice for his kids. So, he is the subject, is making verb, rice object, which is directly acted upon by he. They have bought a new house. That teacher taught mathematics. That teacher subject taught verb, mathematics, object. Raju was playing cricket. He will invite his friends. So if you look at all these sentences, each sentence is in a particular tense. So we have to identify the tense to learn the conversions of active voice to passive voice. So let us look at these sentences again. Okay, let us identify in which tense all these sentences are. So the first sentence, that is, she drives an SUV car, is a simple present tense. She does it almost every day. That is why it is a simple present tense. And if you look at the verb drives, you can easily identify that it is simple present tense. Next sentence, which tense is it? He is making rice for his kids. Just now he is making. Okay, at present, he is preparing rice for his kids. So that particular sentence is in continuous tense. Which continuous tense? Present continuous tense. They have bought a new house. So that is present perfect tense. That teacher taught mathematics. Can you identify which tense it is? Yes, it is simple past tense because it's already done. Taught. Okay, that is the past form of the verb teach. So we can identify that it is already, the action is already done, and so it is what it is, simple past tense. Raju was playing cricket. So this happened in the past and it was a continuous action in the past. That is why the sentence is Raju was playing. Okay. He will invite his friends. He has not invited his friends yet. He will invite in the future. So it is future time, simple future. So in this particular slide, we have passive voice. So passive voice are used in some context like a science lab experiment or if the doer does not make much difference to the action. Usually we prefer in writing active voice. The passive voice is not so accepted, but in certain specific context we use passive form of the verb, like when we write the lab record, definitely we have to write it in passive voice. So one can change the normal word order of many active sentences. so that the subject is no longer active. Instead, it is being acted upon by the verb. So subject is what there, subject is passive. In the earlier sentences that we checked, subject is very active there. We are more interested about who is doing the action, okay, and what action is done. Here, we are not much bothered about the subject. Subject is passive here and hence it is passive voice. So let us look at the first sentence. An SUV car is driven by her. So we are more interested to know which car is driven and is she driving the car. All these things are there in her mind, okay, and the person is not important because we already know that she drives lot of cars, so it is not a kind of surprise for us and we don't want to know that she is still driving, but we are eager to know what kind of car she is driving and is she driving that car properly. Okay, next sentence. Rice is being made by him for his kids. We are curious about the thing that is making and how he is making. Okay, so here the subject is not so important, subject is not active, but a subject is being acted upon by the verb. Verb is important. The form of the verb is important. The aspect of the verb is important. And the object is important. Next sentence. Mathematics was taught by that teacher. Cricket was being played by Raju. His friends will be invited. So all these are the passive forms of the sentences that we discussed earlier in the previous slide. So here also you can easily identify when you look at the conversions. Before going to the conversions as such, we can look at the tenses. First is simple present tense, second is present continuous tense, third is present perfect tense, fourth sentence, mathematics was taught by the teacher is simple past tense, cricket was being played by Raju is past continuous tense, his friends will be invited. What tense is it? Simple future tense, yes. So we need direct objects to convert active sentences into passive forms. So, and only transitive verbs have active and passive voice. Because the subject is being acted upon, such sentences are called passive voice. So, how do we make passive voice? Passive voice are made up of the verb be, that is different forms of be like is, was, were, being and all those things, been, okay. So, all these things we use along with what, along with the past participle form of the verb. For regular verbs, we can add ed form to make it past participle, but for irregular verbs, we don't have a specific rule. For example, for words like write, the past participle form will be written. For read, it is read. For come, it is again come. So let us look at these sentences given here. The boy respected that old woman. Passive voice. That old woman was respected by the boy. So that is how you convert the sentence. You are adding a be form, that is was here, and the past participle form of the verb, that is respected. And this sentence is in simple past tense. If we want to show the person or thing doing the action, we use by. So if the agent is important or if the person is important, then to add that person, we use a word by. Okay, she was loved by her pet dog. We are curious to know who is loving her. Okay, so her pet dog, and before that we add by. The money was given by her friend. So here you have a few examples of passive voice. First sentence, English is spoken all over the world. The rooms have been cleaned. We don't want to know who is cleaning the room, who has cleaned the room. So we haven't mentioned the person here. We have omitted the agent. Breakfast was being served. We are not curious to know who is serving the who was serving the breakfast. So we didn't add the person. The construction will be completed soon. My friends might have been invited to the party. You have conversions. On the left-hand side, you have active voice, and on the right-hand side, you have passive voice. So first is present tense. First three sentences are in different forms of present tense. I'll explain each one of the sentences for you. First one is Suresh changes the flat tire. So this sentence is in simple present tense. Okay? If you observe the verb changes, then you understand that it is in simple present tense. So in passive voice, you have to write the flat tire, that is the object of the sentence given to you, then the be form, that is, and then the past participle form of the verb, that is changed. And after that, you add a by and then the person or the agent. Okay. So let us analyze the sentence again. The flat tire, I've underlined it. It is the object of the sentence that was given to us. So we write that first, and after that we write be form, that is here, because it is present tense. And then you write the past participle form, that is changed. And then you have to add a by, and then the person who is doing the action. Okay. Next sentence. We are going to watch a drama. So which tense is this sentence? We are going to watch a drama. It is present continuous tense. So here the object of this sentence is a drama. So you put a drama in the first, then you write the be form. Is, and then the present participle form, that is going to be watched by us. I have conducted a crash course. So you put a crash course in the beginning, then, no, this sentence is wrong here. Can you correct the sentence? A crash course have been conducted by me. That is the correct form. Okay. A crash course have been conducted by me. One is wrong. That is why I'm giving you the correct sentence. It is a typo error. I have conducted a crash course. So in passive form, as it is present perfect tense, you have to write a crash course have been conducted by me. Then past tense. Mom read the novel in one day. The novel was read by mom in one day. So the novel is the object that you're taking from the sentence. Was is be form, read is participle form, then you add by to mention the agent, that is mom. I was cleaning the house, that is past continuous tense, and then you write the house was being cleaned by me. The staff had watched a safety video. A safety video had been watched by the staff every year. Future, simple future sentence. The teacher will answer the student's question. The student's questions will be answered by the teacher. Yeah, here you have more sentences. You can read them and you can even take a screenshot so that you can observe these sentences. You can take time and then do it on your own also. Okay, just write the part that is given on the left hand side, and then be genuine to yourself. Try to convert it into convert on your own and write the passive forms. You can check the answers here. More examples are given here. It's better that you take a screenshot and observe the sentences. Yes, these are the textual exercises. So they'll not mention which tense it is. You have to identify in which tense that is given, and then you have to convert it into the correct passive form. The active forms are given for you. First sentence, Hari ate 6 puris for dinner. So as the verb is ate, we can identify that it is in past tense, simple past tense. Okay, so take the object first. First, you remove the prepositional phrase from the sentence, the part that comes after preposition. For example, for dinner, you remove that, and then you consider only the part of the sentence, Hari ate 6 puris. So you can understand that Hari is the subject of the sentence, ate is verb, 6 puris, what are they? They are objects. Okay, so you put 6 puris to convert the sentence. You put 6 puris in the beginning, then you write the be form, that is where, because 6 puris are plural. Okay, so you write where, then you write the v3 form of 8, that is eaten. You add by, and then you add the person who is the subject of the sentence that is given to you. Clear? Next sentence, my friend has completed the work. Which tense is the sentence in? It's present perfect tense. So what is the subject in the sentence? My friend. And what is the verb? Has completed. And what is the object? The work. So we put the object first, the work, and then you add has, be form, that is been, then participle form, completed. You add by and the person, my friend. Sunita changed the bed sheet. The bed sheet was changed by Sunita. Be form is was, as the sentence is in simple past tense. We look at the 8th sentence. The Indian team will play the game tomorrow. It is in simple future. Because you can find the verb form, will form, and they have added tomorrow. So it is easy for you to identify. What is the object in the sentence? The game. And then you write will, and you write the be form, be, participle form, played. You add by the Indian team. Yes, you have textual sentences here. You have to convert these sentences into active forms. A refresher course will be attended by the faculty every year. So which tense is this? The sentence is in passive voice, and which tense is it? You tell me. If will comes, then it is future. Okay, so how will you convert the sentence? The faculty will attend a refresher course every year. An application for the new job was sent by her. So here the object is her. We'll put that object as subject. So we have to add a subject pronoun. It is she. She sent an application for the new job. Next one. A beautiful picture was painted by Tony. How will you write it? Which tense is it? It is in past tense, simple past tense. So how do you start the sentence? You start with the person given here, that is the subject. In active voice, is Tony. Tony painted a beautiful picture. That song has been sung really sweetly by the choir. Okay, there is a typo error. That song has been sung really sweetly by the choir. Choir has sung that song really sweetly. I'll repeat it. The choir has sung that song really sweetly. So, you have to change the sentences in such a way that in active voice, you show that the subject is acting. Okay, and in the passive voice, how do you see the action? The action is done to the subject. Okay, so the doer of the action need not be a person always. It can be a thing also. It can be an object also. For example, in a sentence that is in active voice, tsunami caused destruction. So here the doer is what? Tsunami. It's not a person. Destruction was caused by tsunami. So what is the agent here? Agent is tsunami. I've given the answers here. You try to do it on your own and then you can take a screenshot of this and check if it is right or incorrect. Here I have given certain references where you can go and check to learn more about voices. That is all for now. Thank you. Thank you, students.